So in this session, we are going to learn two things. First thing is string concatenation, and the second thing, functions, that is text functions performed on strings. So if you see on the right side, there are so many methods for the object called text. There are so many methods: append, convert to lowercase, convert to uppercase. There are so many things. Get length, length of the string, get subtext, all this. So there are so many functions. You can try one by one, but I will discuss a few things here. Yeah, let us see. String concatenation. So if you see, I'm giving a number, I'm assigning a number 10 to A, and I'm assigning number 5 to B. So let us see, if I say C is equal to A plus B, this is not a string, but just an example I'm telling you. So what it does, because A is also a number here, B is also a number here, so it will add, the number gets added. 10 plus 5, 15 will be stored in the C. So let us print it. Text window, right line, C. So I'm executing it. So it is saying 15. 10 plus 5, 15. It is adding it because both are numbers. So let us say B is not a number. Let us say it is my name, for example. So I'm adding A plus B. So A is a number, but B is a text string, right? So what it will print? So it cannot add 10 and Krishna as numbers. So mathematical operations cannot be performed between number and text. So we are giving a mathematical operation though. So it cannot add because these are not two numbers. What it will do? So let us see. So it is saying 10 Krishna. It is just appending. This is also called concatenation. So let us go ahead. So here also we'll see something like. So let me copy here. We can give in any order. Because my name is this, so I'm adding like this. So A Krishna, B Mohan. So these two words also gets concatenated. So I'm running it. So it's printing like Krishna Mohan. So it is adding Krishna plus Mohan. So this is called concatenation. So we can also give like this. A plus B. And here I'm removing C. I'm printing directly A plus B. These are not two numbers. If they are two numbers, it will print the, it will add two numbers and it will return the sum of those two numbers. But here, these are not numbers. If any of them is a string, it will concatenate. So it will print Krishna Mohan without space because we are not given any space. Yeah, Krishna Mohan is printing, right? So if you want space, either we have to give space here or we have to space here. If you need a space in between, yeah, we can check. So Krishna space Mohan. So this is called concatenation. So let us work on numbers only. Let us say multiplication table, seventh table. B, suppose we need 7 8 jump. So if we say A plus B, it will add 7 plus 8, 15, because both are numbers. We don't want that. So we want to print A, then plus multiplication symbol, plus the value of B, then plus, we need equal to symbol, then again plus, we have to add plus for each. So now we have to print A multiplied by B. So what it should print? 7 into 8 equal to 7 8 jump. whatever it is, 56 or whatever. So I'm running it. So 7 edge of 56. So this is just concatenating here only, because both are numbers, it is multiplying. But here in between we are giving text, so it prints A as it is, it prints X as it is, then value of B, then equal to as it is, and then the product of A multiplied by B. Alright, so this is called concatenation. We are just using plus in between text and number, text and number, text and number, text and number. So this is called the text string concatenation. So let us write a small program for multiplication table. Anyway, although this is not related to concatenation or text, anyway we tried this, so let us just do that. So for example, let us read a table number. Table is equal to text window read number. So we are reading a table, which table we want, so we can also write that. So I'm writing within quotes string. So which table you need. So this will just write this string, which table you need, because we are saying write line and it's reading a number and putting it into table. So let us also write text window write line until which multiplier. So again, let us read a number. So let us read a number, put it into some variable name called multi. Any name, we can give any name. It starts with number, and these variable names can contain. It must start with an alphabetic noun character, and it may contain alphabets, digits, and underscores. But the first letter must be alphabet. Okay. So we are reading two numbers. One is table, and one is the multiplier. And let us print the table. For example, for I is equal to 1 to multiplier. And for here we printing table. Suppose if we are giving a seventh table, 7, but here multiplier should change. So I value. So I value, it starts with 1 till multiplier. Suppose here we are giving 12. So 1 to 12 it should print, right? 1 to 12. So this number, first time 1, second time 2, third time 3, like that till 12. Here it should multiply. Table multiplied by I. Table multiplied. So the product, it should print the product. Right. So we did not format this. Just right click it. Right click. Format program. So it will do the formatting. Means indentation. Suppose let us see, let us run this program. So it says, let us see which table, seventh table, until which multiplier, let us say 12. So it's saying 7 1 7 7 2 12 7 3 21, like this until 7 12 84, it's printing. So this is only to show the concatenation, string concatenation. So I'm printing the number table, I'm printing the symbol X, then printing the multiplier number, then printing equal to symbol, then printing sum. So I will also tell you something like, let us see, program delay. Suppose you want dot delay 100. So after printing each line, if you need some delay, you just want to see slowly, program delay. This is an additional function you can learn. Program delay 100 means 100 milliseconds, which means 1/10 of a second we are waiting after each line. So let us execute again. Okay, so I'm giving 19th table and I want to print till 9 ja. So it is waiting after each line, right? So 19 1 ja 2 19 9 ja prints. So you can give more number also if you want. So let us say 200. If you still want to see even slower, 18 7 ja. Like this we can see. So now we'll see the text functions. So let us say A equal to Krishna and length. Let us put some variable called length, which is text dot get length of A. Or let us put name here. Let us give name. Name is called Krishna. Length is equal to text of get length. So the name is Krishna. Get length means how many characters. So 1 2 3 4 5 6 7. So it should return 7. So let us print it. Text window, right line, length. So I'm executing it. So it is printing 7, right? So instead of a constant value, let us read it. Text window, read. So let us also print a message. Text window, write line, what is your name. So we are printing what is your name, then we'll enter a name. So it will take into name, then it will take a length of that name, text dot get length of name, and put it that length, and then we are printing the length. Let us see. So I am entering some name, which means, so it says 7 characters. Press again. Let us see. Let's try Mary. See, this is 4 characters. So like that. So we only saw get length, but here there are so many other functions. If you just copy here, we can see for the text object there are so many methods. Get subtext, get character, convert to uppercase. If you want to convert to uppercase, we can convert to uppercase. So let us, for example, print the name in uppercase. Right line, name. So instead of just printing the name, text dot convert to uppercase. So let us convert the name to uppercase and print it. So this is the name we are converting to uppercase and printing it. So let us execute. Let us say give some name. So it says 7 characters and it's printing in uppercase. So whichever case we give, whether uppercase, lowercase or middle case, it will convert to uppercase. So now let us check another one. With this knowledge, let us try to do a small program. Suppose for I is equal to length to 1. So we have seen I is equal to 1 to 10 like that. So reverse also is possible. So length, suppose length is 7, right? Suppose if we give Krishna, length is 7, 7 to 1. Here we have to mention step minus 1. So next time it will go with 6, then 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, then it will stop. So let us print text window, not right line, but right. So here what we will print, text dot text dot get subtext, get subtext of name I1. I will explain you what it is. Here n4. So we are entering a name and taking a length. Let us assume I entered Krishna. The length is 7. So the loop will run for 7 times, but in a reverse order. So I is equal to length to 1 means 7 to 1. So first I value will be taken as 7, then it will be taken as 6, then it will be taken as 5, like this up to 1. So here what we are taking, we are from the name the position. Suppose first one is I is equal to 7. So from 7th position we are taking one character, which is nothing but the last character. So again it goes I is equal to 6, because step minus 1 we gave. So again I is equal to 6, that is second character from the last. So the next I is equal to 5, that is from the name 5th character, that is third character from the right. So only one character we are taking. First we are taking 7th character, then 6th character, then 5th character, like that. Reverse order we are taking it and printing it. And we are not printing text right line. If you print right line, it will print each character in one single line. If you write, if you use right instead of right line, it will print side by side. So what we are actually doing is, we are printing the name in reverse order. So let us see, let us run. So I'm just entering Krishna. So it is printing, it is saying 7, then Krishna. It is also printing in the reverse order, K-R-I-S-H-N-A. So in the reverse order it is printing. So after that we should print some enter to go to the next line. Let us see that. So after the loop, text window right line, some dummy line will print it, so that it will go to the next line. So let us execute. Let us say Sattvic. So 7, capital Sattvic, and Sattvic printed in reverse order, S-A-T-H-V-I-K. So in the reverse order it printed. So let's print some other name. Suppose let's print something like this. So Narendra Modi, it's printing in capital letters and in the reverse order. So like that we can try any name, any number of characters. So 13 characters. So first 13th character, then 12th character, then 11th, 10th, like that until first character it prints on the reverse order. So this is about text functions and string concatenation. So you can see a lot of text functions are there. You can try one by one. Yeah, thank you. Let's move to the next and final session.